again, thank you for watching our tip of the week. My name is Phil Baylor from Pave to Innovators, and this week we're going to talk to you about hybrid edging. But before we get started, I just want to ask you to subscribe to us on YouTube, click on the notifications bell for our latest and greatest updates. You can also check us out on Instagram and Facebook, pavetool.com. Check us out there, sign up for our tip of the week. You can get all our tips and tricks on hardscape industry. If you like this video, be sure to give us that thumbs up. Hybrid edging, why? We came up with the hybrid edging because we had a couple industry problems that we saw that were not being solved. Number one, we saw a lot of uplift. A lot of your plastic edging being lifted up out of the ground by either freeze, thaw, or just over time. So our stitching technology with the spike holes being on 60 degree opposing angles, that would allow us to put the spikes in on that angle, stitch it into our base, that's gonna eliminate that uplift. The other problem we saw was a lot of our industry is going towards open grade base. So a clean 3/4 stone base with a number 8 bedding layer, 9 bedding layer, like you see here. Clean stone, there's really no way of attaching edging with a spike. It has no bearing ability, no structural ability. So we created the hybrid stake, the V-shaped stake, which you'll see, and that goes into these V-shaped openings, and that's gonna eliminate that lateral shift in an open grade base. Another nice thing about the aluminum edging, aluminum is very tight and compact, so we can carry a tremendous amount and a small amount of area and weight. And just for instance, equivalent, a pack of edging is 200 linear feet. If we were to do the same thing, say in concrete, that would be 8 buckets or 8 bags of concrete at 80 pounds or 60 pounds bags, plus your water you need to mix it. Keep in mind, concrete is not an ICPI approved edging. Our industry fights concrete. Concrete is a rigid surface made to fight against frost. Our systems are flexible. They're made to flex with the frost. So it's really contrary using concrete for the edging when the system itself is flexible. So a couple of points there that I really wanted to bring to light. I think it's interesting the way we see our industry changing all the time. And this open grade base is one of the areas that we've seen tremendous change. And now we have a solution for edge restraint. So before I get started with my edging, I'm gonna run my quickie sand plow connected to our handle, interchangeable handle. When I drag that, that's gonna give me a nice level setting bed to install my edging on. Once my base is nice and level after using my sand plow, I'm gonna take my hybrid edging and just wiggle it down into that base and make sure the main beam is nice and tight to our pavers. Now I'm ready to install my hybrid stake. Hold your toe against the edging, insert the hybrid stake. A lot of times I'll do just a little bit of a wiggle on this to get it started down in there. Remember the time for the hammer drill. It's just a matter of driving this in. I'm going to skip two. Again, do that little bit of wiggle, holding your toe against it. So sometimes afterwards, when I put the hybrid stake in, if it pulls any kind of material away from the edging here, or if it pulls even away from the main beam, I can get underneath there with my hammer drill, or even just a regular drill, and just fill that back in a little bit. So I'm here with Andrew from Baylor Brothers. Again, today's the first day. Got him on the hammer drill with our quickie hammer bit, using the hybrid stake and driving into our hybrid edging. I just thought I'd just randomly ask here, what'd you think of that experience?
It's a lot easier than what I'm used to.
So a lot easier, a lot less labor, like your arm probably, forearm.
Yeah.
Swinging,
missing, the hammer, yeah.
Chipping pavers.
Yep.
So you'd rather do that or rather hit it in my hand?
I'd rather do this.
It's kind of a no-brainer.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, awesome. Thanks a lot.
No problem.
Thank you again for watching today, our tip of the week. Make sure to subscribe to us on YouTube. Click the notifications bell. Also check us out on Instagram, Facebook, and sign up for our tip of the week. Thank you for letting us help you take the heart out of hardscaping.